Hello, I'm Mr. Arnett Jerry, retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. A friend of mine wants to have the exposition of 1 Corinthians 3.3 onward. And so I thought I'd let him get it done. I have done it many times, but just to stress it, the importance of gospel. Gospel is received if you are predestined, and gospel comes from your heart and not from the book. To receive gospel, you have to eat the flesh of Jesus. When you are young, you are drinking milk, and milk is scriptures. The people in university, they are on milk, old wine. And when they get drunk with the old wine, they desire it, not the new. So they don't have any idea of gospel. Because gospel only comes when your heart is like a little child, clean, as he did in Cana. When he prepared the new wine, he cleansed out all the specks. He rinsed out all the specks of the old wine from the vats. And then he told them to fill with the fresh water. This is the vat which was filled with fresh water, making the heart of the people like little children. And then with the yeast of Holy Spirit is common sense, he brewed the new wine. So common sense is a gift from God. Nobody can have it unless he giveth. Out of the 12 laborers, Peter did not have the common sense. He had only the milk letters from the rabbi. And he used to carry dagger. When Jesus said, if somebody present the other cheek, he said, no, I can't agree with him. I will hit him back. That's why he hit the servant, you know, of the temple priest when they came to catch Jesus. Now, in Jesus, we don't impose views. So that's why Jesus did not tell him not to carry the sword with him. Let him do what he likes it. We have total freedom in Christ Jesus. So only when you are of Holy Spirit, and this is the temple of God, then Christ rests in your heart. And when Christ rests in your heart, it makes you solitary, and only the solitary can pass through the narrow gate that leads to the vineyard of our Father, with the true wine, Christ Jesus, is planted. Unless you graft yourself to that true wine, you cannot preach gospel. So the people who are clever, they hate the passage, new narrow gate, because narrow gate is a killing of his word. So they hate the heat of killing. They don't want to speak the gospel truth. Clever people like Judas Iscariot. So they hate grafting themselves to Christ Jesus and becoming his apostle. So that's why Judas Iscariot loved Mammon, though he kept away from the killer. And the not grafting himself to Jesus are listening to him. So what came of the mouth? Mouth was of Jesus. Heart was of Christ. So what came out of the mouth of Jesus, you should eat it with these ears. These are the ears. That's why Jesus said, let them hear who have ears. Ears mean mouth, spiritual mouth. Eat it with this spiritual mouth. Take it to your heart, digest it, and then bring it out from your own mouth. What Jesus has explained to you of your own authority, then you are the epistles of Christ Jesus, and preach gospel from your own mouth in honor of Christ Jesus, which is, you become the epistle of Christ Jesus. You have understood it, and you can explain it, and you can preach with authority as Jesus did. That is what you become, the friends of Jesus. Now, this mouth we eat as a kosher, non-kosher, and it comes out from the other end at the bottom, and you don't want to touch it, so smelly. But this food which Jesus has provided, a living bread, when you eat with the ear, it brings fragrance, just the opposite of the smell. I hope with this introduction, now I can explain that 1 Corinthians 3:3, for as much as ye are manifestly declared to be the epistle of Christ, ministered by us, Christ is inside you, epistles of Christ. Unless you have Christ in your heart, you can't preach gospel. Christians, they are people of the book. They learn the letters of the book. And when they are asked questions, they vomit it out. But what is not written in the book, they can't tell you. For example, you know, the Yahweh, who is the creator of nature at large, which you see with two eyes, is a natural, demiurge God, creating natural parts, into which the soul of our Father, supernatural Father, is infused, make you living. Now, if you ask these people of the book, university professors, Yahweh created Adam only, and then he made Eve out of the rib of Adam. And why not he created Eve also along with the Adam? And I bet hardly anyone will be able to answer, and that is the test for the twice born. So twice born, not easy to find, very hard to find. And if you understand that man is made in the reflection of God, in God, you know, we have God is our Father, and our Mother is a Holy Spirit, and we are the sons who represent Him. Even in flesh, you could be a female, but still you are a son. You are the Son of the Most High. That's what Christ Jesus made us. You are a saint. There is no saintess, you know. Only saint. Whether you are a male or a female, both are saint. Saint Fortina, the woman which had five husbands, Samaritan woman, those spiritual husbands, I have explained it. But nobody can take it because gospel is by grace of our Father. Peter was with Jesus all the time. He could not grasp the gospel because he was once born. Only once when Jesus asked him, what you think I am? Peter said, you are the living Christ of living God. Then Jesus told him, don't tell to anybody else. So that when he got it, you know, that Jesus stressed, yes, flesh and blood, or flesh and soul, cannot make you understand the things of God unless you have the gift of Holy Spirit from God. Holy Spirit is common sense. And the people, the university people, they have no common sense. And if they have common sense, they should answer that why Yahweh did not create Eve as well. And this is a good question. If you understand this one, you can understand peace in the world. You can understand why in Syria they are fighting and what is the solution to it. So Christ is inside. Christ is manifested when you preach gospel. If you are a Christian, you will open the Bible and vomit it out. And there are cross references. The person listening get fed up and we say, oh, get lost. Doesn't bother. Gospel is very pleasant. And it keeps you bound. As Christ Jesus was bound to Samaritan woman. Samaritan woman was asking questions which were very sensible. Even his laborers were listening to attentively what she was asking and what he was replying. And he was so pleased with her that to her he revealed that I am the Christ. To his own laborer he said, don't tell anybody that I am the Christ, because Messiah is not known to everyone. Only those who are predestined. Jesus went to the temple, and over there the Pharisees were sitting there, the very proud, you know, men of letters. And Jesus asked them, whose son is Messiah? They said, David. David is concerned with this one, Jesus, Yeshua. Messiah is concerned with heart, is a title. Title to those who know his word. As you have professors in chemistry, because they know chemistry subject, they become professors. And so those who know the word, they become their Christ. So the Christ are born of the word. And word was in the beginning and is forever. So those Pharisees will see, none of them knew what Messiah stands for, or what Messiah is. Then Jesus told them, I was before Abraham and before Isaac. Then they laughed at him because they were men of letters, drunk with the old wine. They laughed, hey, you are only 40. You are just boasting. That's why Jesus said, don't tell everyone that I am the Christ. Christ is known to those who are of Holy Spirit, as Fortina was, Samaritan woman at well. Men of letters call her a prostitute. You can see what is the difference. Now Christ, epistle of Christ, ministered by us, written not with ink, as scriptures are, you know, written in ink on paper, but with the Spirit of the living God. Spirit of the living God is by grace. Unless you have the grace of Holy Spirit, you can't understand gospel. Peter could not understand. So the Spirit of living God means Holy Spirit is the one which make you and enable you to understand epistles of Christ or gospel. Not in tables of stone, tablets of stones. On stone, you know, Moses wrote down. Then they copied it and they made the other thing. That means the scripture, moral laws, which are the reflection of the gospel, they could be written down in ink on paper. But gospel itself is not written down. So if you understand scripture, if you know reflection that I'm living, then you can perceive that I have a soul in my body that makes me living. So if you understand scripture, that is the written, what is written, then you know the source of scripture, which is gospel. So that is what Jesus said, if you can't understand why Yahweh did not create Eve also, you won't understand gospel. So Thomas said, you know, first know what you see with your two naked eye, then what is not seen would be known to you. This is same thing, you know, if you understand scripture, then gospel would be known to you. If you know gospel, then you can explain scriptures to the very minute details as Jesus was doing in synagogues. Not in tablets of stone or scriptures, but in fleshly tablets of the heart. Gospel is of heart. Jesus said, if you put money in the bank or put it bury it, it can get rusted or can be stolen. But your treasures, which are gospel treasures, are where your heart is. Nobody can steal. If they multiply, more you spend, more they are multiplied. And such trust have we through Christ to God word. Christ to God word. Okay? Not you misuse the Holy Spirit and make money like Judas Iscariot was doing, or these hireling dog-collared people are doing, cheating people in the name of Jesus. They are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. They themselves can't enter into the royal kingdom of God. How can they make you enter? So you need to be solitary to find that narrow gate yourself. Nobody is going to find it for you unless you are predestined. You can't know that gate. And such trust have we through Christ to God word, not that we are sufficient of ourselves. That means gospel does not come from a man. Gospel come from our, we are preaching not what we know, what our Father has shown us. That means gospel is not my, what I'm saying is not my authority, is not mine. It is the gospel is the authority of our Father. When we explain it in details, then we explain it everything, leaving no stone unturned. Whatever we say is according to the will of our Father. We are not doing our will. That Islam, you know, that you see it today, is of Insh Mullah, is what the Mullah says, you know. Allah is sun, primary source of light. The Inshallah Islam was preached by Christ Jesus and Christ Nanak. Remember when Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, he sent two of his laborers went to a village to get ready to receive him, but they said they don't want to know him. So they came back to Jesus, put that village on fire as Elijah did. He said, you don't know to what spirit ye are of. I have come to do the will of my Father, not my will. And that is called Islam, Inshallah. So God word, not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves, that we not, it is not my own making. Words are not on my own making, it is the word of our Father. But our sufficiency is of God. Of God, you know, by grace of our Father, I received this word that I am preaching gospel. It's not my words. I'm not rendering my own praises. I'm praising our Father, who also hath made us able ministers of the New Testament. Able minister, that we are can preach gospel with authority as the royal priest of the New Testament. Royal priests are those who give to the church and not take money from the people. The priest used to get 1/10 of the crop, everything, as these hireling dog-collar priests are doing today. They are fulfilling Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. They are creating sectarian riots. They are creating all this hell in the world now. So if you want peace, go to the, become a royal priest, solitary, and preach gospel from your heart. Don't take money when they, some people go to church and they deliver, take over the service, and at the end they put money in his pocket and he happily goes home. That is not royal priest. They are hireling, dog collar priests. If you have sufficient money, why you take the other people's money? So, minister of the New Testament, not of the letter that you can read and you can understand gospel. This New Testament letters, they are dead without the Holy Spirit. But of the Spirit means, for the letter killeth. Letter killeth means if you study this one, you don't understand, you vomit them out and then you create controversy between Islam and Christian and this and that. But if you know the Spirit, then you can tell them, hey, your Islam is of Mullah, my Islam is of Allah. But otherwise you keep on fighting with each other because you are spiritually blind. Blind people have fight on the basis of letters as they do in universities. They take the skin of the letters without understanding. And when I went to Oxford University and I asked them question to university professors, dean of the university professor, I asked him, who died on the cross, Jesus or Christ? He said, if you take my opinion personal, it is Jesus who died. But officially I can't say anything. Now the person who doesn't know the difference between Jesus and Christ, and he is the head of the Christianity department, dean, theology dean. So what type of students he will be producing? So they are super blind, producing super blind dog collared priests. So be careful of them. They are the troublemakers. So letter killeth, but the Spirit giveth life. Spirit, Holy Spirit. Through Holy Spirit you understand the message of God, gospel, and it gives you life. Wherever you go, you can live in peace. You can create a heaven around you. Your inside, you get royal peace. Royal kingdom of God is inside you. Kingdom of heaven is outside in law and order. The key of the kingdom of heaven was with the rabbis. And the royal kingdom is inside you. You receive peace of mind through gospel understanding and gospel preaching. But if the ministration of death was written and engraven in stones was glorious. That means if these letters, Moses gave you the law or written letters, if they were so glorious, you know, and you are so proud, so that the children of Israel could not steadfastly behold the face of Moses, the Moses who gave them that letters, law, they could not see his face because he had Christ in his heart. With Christ in his heart, he wrote Torah. So they could not see his face because he was so intelligent and so good at scriptures. As university professor, if he's a very good one, then you are very, very pleased to see his face, that this man is very, very brilliant. And so was Moses, very brilliant. And they could not see him, you know. That's why Moses saw himself, the face of God. That means he got the gospel. And to the people, he showed the back. Face is inside, back is this one. Steadfastly behold the face of Moses, for the glory of this, his countenance. That means so. Remember that Stephen, when he went to the temple, he gave a good lesson to them in the name of Moses, because he was one of the 70 outer circle laborers who were being prepared for John the Baptist. John the Baptist was the last prophet, Elijah. law and prophet were till John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. No more prophet after him. So, the glory of, his countenance, which glory was to be done away. Engraven stones were glorious so that the children of Israel could not steadfastly behold the face of Moses for the glory of his countenance, which glory was to be done away. That means that is to be gone now. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. So no more prophet after that. Jesus was the very son of our Father. He came from the family of our Father, which is Father, God. Holy Spirit is our mother, and the one who represents Father is always Son, you know. As in this word, it's the Son who carries the seed of the Father and not the woman. Woman is the counterpart of God for supplying the blood. She has no boundary. She can go from one country to the other, but the men have boundaries. Which glory was to be done away? That means that is gone now. We are going to show you the very face of God. He showed you the back. Scriptures are the back reflection of the gospel. And we are going to have the gospel itself. How shall not the ministration of the Spirit be rather glorious? So if the Moses are the face of God, and he showed you the back of the God, which is Scripture, and how glorious would be if you yourself see the face of God, which Moses saw, the very source of Scriptures. For if the ministration of condemnation be glory, if the ministration of the condemnation be glory, in that, in law, you are condemned. Are you bound, you know, by the law, and you commit sin. Sin is condemnation. So that's why you have a rabbi to administer the law, or the priest. But we are royal priests. Royal priests do not have anybody to administer them. We have fellowship of royal priest. Gospel is received on individual basis. We are no more as children of the classroom where the rabbi is the teacher and teaches you the dead letters. We are ourselves Christ, solitary, not royal priest, not priest. We give to the church, we don't take out of the church. We are not thieves like Judas Iscariot. For if the ministration of condemnation be glory of Moses, you know, who put the law and bound you, Jesus set you free, much more doth the ministration of righteousness exceed in glory. What you need to be, why you want to go to the church, so you be good, you know. Now, if you are righteous, if you don't cheat anyone, and you are righteous, you know, you don't need to go to church. And this righteousness, if you are a righteous person, people will admire you. That man is trustworthy. You can go to him, he won't cheat you. And that is the righteousness is attained when your heart is cleansed by his word. When your heart is whitewashed by his word, and then you become righteous. And when you are righteous, you are representing our righteous Father, God. Then you are the Son of the Most High. When you are the Son of the Most High, you don't need to read letters. You don't need Bible or anything. You have to worship as in Samaritan woman. Jesus told everything. Very good parable, John 4. If somebody understands that, he will understand what I'm speaking about. Then Jesus said, you know, when she, the woman, told her, the Jewish people say that the salvation is of going to the temple, worshipping temple in Jerusalem. Temples made by men, human hand. And our forefather used to worship on that hill. The temple used to be built on higher ground, close to heaven. So in Jesus, we are to be humble, lower than everyone. So Jesus said then, you don't need to go to those brick-built temples anymore. This is your temple. God is in you if you speak the truth and worship Him in righteousness. But if you are a liar and cheat people, then Satan is in you, not God. And you will be killed like hypocrite, this Hillary and Trump. They are greatest hypocrite you can come across. Whatever comes from their mouth are sugar-coated sermons. So when they give you sugar-coated sermon, where will they lead the nation? To hell, not to heaven. So you are to wake up and stand up in righteousness. Gospel is not for everyone. 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. You could be very few, but you have to stand up. In the time of Jesus, how many knew Jesus was the Christ? Very few, because He told His laborers not to tell anyone that He is the Christ. Christ is known to the people who have Christ in their heart. No Christ in your heart, no Christ you can understand. This gospel of Christ Jesus, you can't understand without Christ in your heart. If you have book knowledge in your head, then you can't understand, because you are drunk with the old wine of the letters. Unless you get the things out of your head, like washing those wine vats which became empty at Cana, and they were rinsed out with clean water of the old wine to make it fresh heart like little children, then you get gospel. So I hope I've explained it quite well, and my friend will be happy to have this exposition. His name is Bradley Dinkum. I hope I don't pronounce it right. My memory is short. Old man, dementia. So, our Father God blesses you.